Hi everyone, Nick Credicus of Nick's Seasonal Decor here, and we're going to be creating a beautiful bird nest using a kit we put together with Jacobsen, so I will have the link in the description of this video as well as the comments in case you're interested in these kits. But to start off with, we're going to take some of this angel vine, and I really like this product because you can maneuver it and the stems don't break as easily as grapevine, and we're just kind of rotating it into a circle to get our shape of a bird nest. And then what I'm doing now is I'm coming back in with a little bit of 22 gauge florist wire and just securing the end so that it stays in a circle and it doesn't fall apart, even though this angel hair does hold its shape greatly. So personally, I love the look of the twigs sticking out everywhere, so I don't mind the natural approach, but of course you can trim it up if you would like to. But now we're coming back in with some hot glue and adding some of the moss that came with the kit. And the moss is a big important step because it really creates a natural look for your bird's nest and makes it look as though it's aged. You don't want this thing to be perfect, you want to have some imperfections, as real bird nests aren't overly perfect. Of course they're round, but they have twigs jetting out in every different direction. So I'm just layering in moss, making sure we added enough hot glue. Now we're coming back in with one of my favorite spring florals, which is Forsythia, and you get one of these sprays in your kit. So I'm just breaking them down about 4 to 6 inches, and since they are wired, we are going to bend them to shape and kind of give them a little bit of a curl or a curve to wrap around the bird nest. We also have another option available to you, which is my personal favorite, the cherry blossom. So feel free to choose either the Forsythia kit or the cherry blossom kit, but we're just adding some more Forsythia around. We do want this to be nice and full, and I'm figuring it'll take about the entire spray. So these bird's nests look great anywhere. What I actually did with my cherry blossom bird nest is I created it a little bit larger and I placed it at the bottom of my staircase, and I think that's the perfect location for it. It's something different. It brings in a little bit of spring color, some florals, and obviously some natural products as well. These would also look great in wreaths, swags, lanterns. You could have them displayed in little centerpieces. And the nice thing about these kits is you can make at least 10 of them. You can create a very large one, you can do small ones, as small as a couple inches. The angel vine is very easily maneuverable, and you can bend it to shape. So you should be able to get at least a dozen or so small to medium-sized bird nest. But now what we're going to do is we're going to come back in with some of these beautiful eggs that are also in the kit. They have them in green, they have them in a lighter pink, and also a darker pink. So I chose a lighter pink to match with the Forsythia. But here's how it turned out. So here's the cherry blossom one that I was talking about at the bottom of my staircase. We also just stuck a little bunny head in it just for fun, but now we have the Forsythia one, which is obviously different. So feel free to choose whichever one you would like. Thank you all so much for watching this, and hopefully it inspired you to get crafty and create your own bird nest. Bye everyone!